If lowercase x is a member of capital X, lowercase y is a member of set capital Y, and lowercase z is a member of set capital Z, which of the following could have a value of 23? So let's look at each of these. So x times y times z. So you're going to take something from this set, something from this set, and something that from that side, and multiply them together. Well, if you did that, you're going to get a non-prime number. Maybe you pick 1 from set x, but then you're going to have to pick a 2 from set y, or a 3 or 4, and then a 3, 4, 5. So you're going to get things like 1 times 2 times 3, or 1 times 3 times 3. No matter what, especially when you look at these last two sets, you're going to get the product of at least two primes, or you might even take the product of a composite in a prime, or two composites. So there's no way multiplying those three, especially a member from these last sets that don't have one in them, that you're going to get a prime number like 23. 23's factors are clearly only 23 and itself. It doesn't have a 2, a 3, or a 4 as a factor. It doesn't have a 5 as a factor. And so we could rule that out. Now let's think about it. X plus Y plus Z. Can we make that equal to 23? So let's see, 23 is a lot larger than these numbers. Let's see if we pick the largest number in each of these sets and see if we can get to 23. So 3 plus 4 plus 5, these are the largest members of each of those sets, and this still only gets us to 12. So there's no way we're going to be able to get to 23. Now let's see, x plus y times z. X plus y times z. Well, I see a way of doing that. X plus y times, let me do this in a different color. X plus y times z. What if, let's see, we can get to 20 by multiplying 4 times 5, and then you add a 3. So this could be 3 plus 4 times 5. And so we'll go with that one. Which of the following could have a value of 23? That one. And we can only pick one choice, so we know we're already done. But we could verify that we can't get there with these other ones. So let's see, x squared plus y squared plus z squared. This one is tempting. It's tempting just because you could get numbers large enough. But if you play around enough, you would have trouble finding a combination that adds to 23. X times y plus z. So there's, if you wanted to get as large as possible, you'd do 3 times 4. So you could try 3 times 4 and then plus some z. But then in this case, this is going to be 12 plus z. 12 plus z, z would have to be 9. You'd have to find a 9 in this third set. There's clearly no 9, so you could rule that one out as well. So we go with C.